Welcome to our KPC Daily Devotional. Let me begin by reading from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 7, and I'll start in verse 36. One of the Pharisees asked Jesus to eat with him, and he went into the Pharisee's house and took his place at the table. And a woman in the city who was a sinner, having learned that he was eating in the Pharisee's house, brought an alabaster jar of ointment. She stood behind him at his feet, weeping, and began to bathe his feet with her tears and to dry them with her hair. And then she continued kissing his feet and anointing them with the ointment. Now, when the Pharisee who had invited him saw it, he said to himself, "If this man were a prophet, he would have known who this is and what kind of woman is touching him, that she's a sinner." Jesus spoke up and said to him, "Simon, I have something to say to you." "Teacher," he replied, "speak." "A certain creditor had two debtors. One owed him 500 denarii and the other 50. When they could not pay, he canceled the debts for both of them. Now, which of them will love him more?" Simon answered, "Well, I suppose the one for whom he canceled the greater debt." And Jesus said to him, "You have judged rightly." Then turning toward the woman, he said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? I entered your house. You gave me no water for my feet, but she has bathed my feet with her tears and dried them with her hair. You gave me no kiss, but from the time I came in, she has not stopped kissing my feet. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she has anointed my feet with ointment. Therefore, I tell you, her sins, which were many, have been forgiven. Hence, she has shown great love. But the one to whom little is forgiven loves little." And then he said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." But those who were at the table there with him began to say among themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" And Jesus said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." This is a devotional from my second volume, Your Inner Dog, Finding Your Place in the Human Pack, and is entitled, Duncan is Happy. Duncan is a happy dog. He's a wire-haired dachshund, meaning he isn't your average wiener dog. Yes, he has the long body and short legs, but he's overall larger than your familiar dachshund. His hair is coarse and shaggy, mostly black with streaks of rusty brown. They were bred in Germany as fierce hunting dogs, sturdy and short, to chase badgers and muskrats out of their tunnels. And Duncan has those strong hunting instincts. Good thing, he needed them. Nobody knows how he ended up out on his own. He clearly started out around people. Did he get lost? Or run away? Was he put out? Still young, he was found alone and bedraggled in a swampy and unpopulated part of the county. He had been hunting for his food, sleeping in the brush. He ended up at the county animal shelter. They named him Perry. The early voting site was next door to the animal shelter. That's how my wife found him. She swears she had not planned on walking into the shelter after voting, but it happened. She called me immediately to make sure I was coming to vote, and, "Oh, check out this dog, please." Of course, we ended up with him. He never answered to Perry, which I don't blame him. So I tried out different names, read a list, until his head jerked up. He knew what his name ought to be and who he really was. It was Duncan, which is Celtic for dark warrior. Kind of suited him, I thought, a black dog who had fought and survived. So Duncan has been with us ever since. He is a very happy dog. He runs and plays constantly. He likes to climb into your lap backwards. We haven't figured that one out yet. Lies there with a big dog grin, tongue half hanging out. He likes his food, likes his bed, likes his playmates, likes his petting and his treats. Hardly anything he doesn't like. Rescue dogs tend to be happy dogs, or at least happier than dogs who were raised with security and privilege. Privileged dogs do not know deprivation, and so they take much for granted. Rescue dogs, though, have experienced abuse or neglect. They've gone hungry, or they've been in danger. They've been lonely or lost. They appreciate what they find in a rescue home: dependable food supply, safety, companionship, comfort, kindness, touch, play. They know what it is to live without these things, and they're grateful when they have them. Duncan has further reason to be happy that he will never know or understand. The shelter staff had already postponed his put-down date once, but they could not delay it again. We adopted him 3 days before his end date. Duncan was bought with a price and was quite literally brought from death to life. Jesus once said that someone who has been forgiven much loves much, meaning that if you've been in bad places, seen hard times, and done bad things, you will be more appreciative of the blessings and second chance you do receive. Duncan will never grasp how his life was saved at the last minute. But he does know that he has been brought from a hard and lonely life to a good, contented life. He's grateful, and his gratitude makes him constantly happy. If you know Jesus Christ, then you too have been bought with a price and have been brought from death into life, like Duncan. You will know how hard life can be without a master, and the sheer relief that comes with finding him, or rather, by being found by him. Gratitude makes you happy. If you do not know him, you're still wandering around in the scrub of life, eking by alone and lonely. But rest assured, there is a master who calls you by your real name and wants to take you home with him. I hope you have a blessed day. Goodbye.